watch this. You gotta watch this. My program hits you so hard, makes me say, oh my word. Thank you for watching me. It's telly, but not going on. See, it feels good. There's outtakes too. Comedy gets and clips, it's true. So sit back, don't move too much. This is a show you can't touch. So hack attack. Thank you. Good day to ye cockers, one and all. We've got loads of drama in store for you because today's Hacky Time is all about the fascinating art of the soap opera. But first of all... Oh, hang on. There's a problem. I've lost me script. Oi, Herman, do you mind? I'm doing my bit now.
Sorry, Hacker. Oh,
now, where was I? Oh, yes. I've lost me script. Derek, what do you think you're doing?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Hacker. I'm just getting some practice in before my next cornet lesson. Woo-hoo!
Well, do it in your own time, please. Now, what was I saying? Oh, yes, I remember now. I've lost me script! And you lot could shut up as well. Oh, I'm livid here. But on the bright side, I've found me script. And it says it's time for the menu. Derek, do the honours, if you would.
Coming up, friendly banter.
That doesn't make sense.
You don't make sense.
High fashion. Plus...
Do you have frog's legs?
Yes.
Then you better go and get that scene too, love. And if I see another musical instrument during the course of this programme, I will trump in all your packed lunches. Oh, hello, yes. Now, as I was saying, today's show is all about soap operas, what are always on the telly. So we've got one of the biggest stars of Coronation Street joining us, except she doesn't know it yet. Wealth Herman, get her!
Yes, Mr. Hacker.
I'll fire up the vine! Ha, 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 ha!
Rita, I've borrowed one of your snazzy cardies to go out in. Is that all right? Oh, what?
Off you go, Wilf.
What's going on?
Off we go.
Hello? Driver? Driver? Does my agent know about this?
Mercy.
Please welcome today's special guest from Coronation Street. It's Jennie McAlpine, who plays Fizz Stay.
Firstly, it's Jennie McAlpine, and secondly, what's going on here, Hacker?
You're my guest on today's Hacker Time.
And what does that entail?
30 minutes of total and utter nonsense, basically.
Oh, and what makes you think I'll stay for that?
Well, I've got a lovely hot pot. You lot down on Coro always seem to be eating hot pot.
Oh, well, if that's the case. Yeah, I'm all yours.
Bout in. Bring on the hot pot!
That's not a hot pot.
Yes, it is, love. She's a pot, and she's very hot. Now that's sorted, it's time to educate the audience on the subject of you. Here's everything you need to know about Jennie McAlpine.
McAlpine!
Bless you! Pull that lever, me old cocksparrow! Jennie McAlpine is a TV woman who's got red hair. She's played Fizz in Coronation Street since Victorian times. More recently, Fizz was sent to trial for... trumping. Oh, not again! Sorry, there was beans in the canteen. The problem's so bad that the rest of the cast choose to stand at least one car's distance away from her. Things have gone from bad to worse of late, and after getting arrested at a funeral for trumping, she ended up in prison, where her cellmate made hurtful comments about her tabard. But her trumping problems just won't stop. Sorry! Will you just stop it with the beans, please? It got so bad, she even managed to clear everyone out of Ailey Cropper's wedding. Look at Ailey, she's furious, look! So that's all you need to know about Jennie McAlpine. What did you make of that?
Well, Hacker, it was factually incorrect.
You're factually incorrect.
That doesn't make sense.
You don't make sense.
Right, I'll be going now.
You'll be going now.
Thank goodness for that.
No, don't go. Don't go, Jennie. I've got a proper interview prepared for you.
Right, all right. I'll stay as long as he's sensible.
Jennie, you've got absolutely nothing to worry about.
I can hear you, you know.
It's awkward, isn't it? Oh, all right then. Question one. You appear on a programme called Coronation Street. Mm. On what road is that programme set?
Coronation Street.
Mm. What a confusing show it is, this. Now, your character is called Fizz Stape.
Yes.
But before she got married, her name was Fizz Brown.
Yeah.
Fizz Brown. Is that a medical complaint?
No.
Next question.
Yes.
What is your favourite soap?
Coronation Street.
Hold on, I've not finished the question.
Oh.
It was, what's your favourite soap? A lavender scented bar or one of those antibacterial hand washes?
This is not a sensible interview, Hacker.
Why?
It's not sensible.
Now, Jenny, I'm thinking of moving house. I've got an estate agent brochure down here all about Weatherfield.
Right.
There it is. That's where Coronation Street is.
Yeah.
And it says in the last couple of years, there's been a massive tram crash. At least 5 of the residents have been to prison, including you, you naughty woman. And worst of all, you can't ride your bike with all them cobbles. No, yes!
What more do you want?
Any road. I love Coronation Street, me. I was even in an episode once with Ryan Hayley Cropper. Do you remember it?
No, I'm pretty sure that didn't happen.
Well, it truly did happen, cockers. Have a gander at this.
Roy Cropper here.
Hi, Roy. It's your old friend Hackety Dog here. Guess what? I've been working on my allotment and I've harvested a very large marrow.
Oh, really? Well, that is very late in the season.
Well, I've been treating the soil with goat manure, like you told me.
Even so, it is quite unusual.
Anyway, I was wondering if you fancy coming over. I could serve it up with a bit of fried mince and a rich tomato and basil sauce.
I'm afraid not. I'm sorry.
Not even if I use my best crockery?
Perhaps another night.
All right. I'm just so lonely.
Ha, 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 ha.
Roy, there's no need to laugh at my misery.
Thank you for calling.
The cheek of it. I'll phone Norris instead. Oh, I've not got his number.
How can you know it's his number?
Oh, have you got him on speed dial?
Yeah.
That's funny, isn't it?
Of course I have.
Now, Jennie McAlpine, have you ever noticed that when everything's going well in a soap, some bad news comes along and ruins everything in a dramatic fashion? Have you noticed that?
Yeah, it does, it does.
Oh, no! I'll just get this. Oh, who could possibly be ringing me now? Everything's going so well. Hello? Oh, no. I don't believe it. How can this be? Please say it isn't so. What's that? It is so. No! I can't believe it. Tragic news. All right, then. Goodbye. Goodbye. I will.
Hacker, you all right? What was all that about?
Oh, I don't know. I couldn't hear him. It was a bad line. Something about a wolf or something. Anyway, what's next, Derek?
I think you'll find I'm next, Ducky. Hoo-hoo! It's Derek time.
Oh, no, you don't. This is my show, Derek. You're not polluting my airwaves with your nonsense.
Not even if I threaten to show the photograph.
Not the photograph.
Hold on, have you seen it at all?
Yeah, have I seen it? It's all round Coronation Street. We've got it pinned up in the cabin.
All right, Derek, you win. Do your show.
Woo-hoo!
And then shred that photograph.
Here we go then, me ducks. Here's me sting. Woo-hoo! It's Derek time. Hello again. On today's show, we haven't got time to show you the cat that's sick of Derek time. Or the chicken that's sick of Derek time. Come on, Mr. Chicken. Wake up. How can you be bored of me? I'm dead exciting. But we do have time to show you one of the greatest video clips of all time. It's a frog on a bench. I wonder what he's doing. Maybe he's just waiting for the number 51 bus to Chesterfield. Maybe he's basking in the sun on the way to the library to return some overdue books. Or maybe he's just waiting to be towed away. Towed. Do you get it? Like a frog. It sort of works. It's like a joke, isn't it? I've disgraced myself again. Back to you, Hacker.
Derek, you've disgraced everyone with that behaviour. Oh, I'm furious. Now, Jennie McAlpine.
McAlpine!
I do love Coronation Street. I really, really, really do. I love Rita.
Ooh!
I love Norris Nozzercole. I love Ken Barlow's Immaculate Side Party.
Oh, yeah, he's got a lovely head of hair.
He's got a fabulous mane going on there. But there's one thing I cannot stand.
What?
It's Hayley Cropper's unsightly red anorak. No, it's a disgrace. I love the woman, but her taste in cookware makes my blood boil.
Oh, that's a bit mean, Hacker.
Do you know what, Jenny? There's only one way I can communicate my feelings on this matter. And that is through the medium of song. Cue the music, me old cocker. Up in Greater Manchester, there is a woman in a cafe with a cheeky smile and raven hair. She is a treat for all to see. She goes by the name of Hayley, and her husband's a man called Roy. They live on a backstreet terrace in a marital state of joy. But one thing about this woman that constantly gets my goat is that wizenry piece of fabric allegedly called a coat. Anorak, red anorak, threadbare and slightly torn. Anorak, red anorak, shabby and very worn. Anorak, red anorak, object of all my scorn. She's worn that crimson jacket now for more than 14 years, but the checkered lining in the hood still reduces me to tears. I don't know why she still wears it. Maybe she likes the toggles or the zipper and button combo. Their mind really truly boggles. I suppose she thinks that it's trendy. I suppose she thinks that it's cool. But she'll never grace the catwalk in that rancid old cagoule. Anorak, red anorak, threadbare and slightly torn. Anorak, red anorak, shabby and very worn. Anorak, red anorak, object of all my scorn. Jenny, what are you doing wearing that atrocity? What are you thinking of?
Oh, sorry, Hacker. It's just a bit cold.
Oh, I'm furious. You come in here, put the anorak on, I sang about me disdain for it, and you put it on, I'm livid.
Yeah. Yet another despicable episode of Hacker Time. Benjamin, get a pen and paper. We are writing another letter of complaint.
Ah, do we have to, Fran?
Yes, now be quick about it.
Okay.
Here we go. Dear the BBC, why must you spend a whole episode of Hacker Time glorifying soap operas? These shows are totally unrealistic. Real life isn't full of dramatic revelations like that.
Frank, I have a dramatic revelation for you.
Benjamin, what is it?
I've forgotten how to write.
Benjamin!
Oh, that's better. I got those fruits off me, Bonce.
Hacker, did you just hear something?
Oh, it's probably my stomach rumbling, Jenny.
No, it sounded more like cockroaches or something.
Well, that figures. But my stomach is still rumbling. That means make me a sandwich!
But I'm the guest!
Make me a sandwich! Post haste! And don't skimp on the meat paste, love. Come on, you're not doing fiction now. While Jennie McAlpine's doing that, why don't you lot take a look at what's coming up?
Still to come, soap slip-ups.
Pitch boy.
Brilliant bowling and crime capers. Don't go away.
Oh, thanks for the sandwich, Jenny.
Pleasure.
It's not a bad effort. If I was to mark it out of 10, I'd give it an F, I reckon.
All right, thank you very much.
Yeah. Now, Jenny off Coronation Street, your character Fizz works in a clothing factory. What sort of garments does she make?
Knickers.
Oh, Jennifer! There's no need to be rude. I was asking a perfectly reasonable question.
No, I'm saying that's what we stitch, knickers.
Oh, I see, knickknacks. But I tell you what, though, to look at Fizz, you wouldn't think she works in the fashion industry, would you? I mean, look at the state of this fabric-based travesty.
What's wrong with that?
I think your character needs some advice from the fashion experts. And I know the very people. Stay there! And make me another sandwich! Here we go! You all right, everybody?
Hello, Hacker!
Are you all well?
Yeah!
Good. Hey,
Do you reckon you can help me become a proper stylish celebrity? Very well! Set to it and design me some garments, good people. Hello, Ben. What have you drawn?
It's a shirt with extendable arms and extendable bottoms.
You said extendable bottoms! Bottom! 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 Oh, and your outfit for me, what is in it?
A skirt and blue boots.
Oh, I'd love to wear a skirt and blue boots, but, I've not got the legs for it. No! Connor, what have you drawn?
I've drawn the cracker stacker.
That rhymes with hacker.
It's got a jetpack at the back.
Ah, what an amazing thing. Bottom! Right, you lot, let's hit the catwalk. Herman, bring in the box of stuff.
Here you go, hacker.
Up now, we've got Alicia here. Oh, what are those? Rubber gloves? She certainly will clean up when she makes her name big in the fashion world, baby. Coming up now is Tanisha. Look at her saunter down the catwalk with her fabulous tiara, which looks a little bit like it's from free with some cereal or something. Up now, we've got Rebecca, who's sporting a lovely chicken hat and some undies. Uh-oh, they've fallen down. Knickers, please. So what have we learned today? Number one, clothes come in a variety of different shapes, colours and sizes. Number two, clothes are an essential part of everyday life. And number three, look, I'm not wearing any clothes. Oh, I'm naked. Oh, my privets are everywhere. Right, that's it, I'm out of here. Thanks for all your help, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah, now I must get back to the studio. You can't be having much fun there without me.
The street light, because there's no place I can go. Street light, it's the only life I know.
All right, cockers, I'm back. What in the name of a gibbon's left armpit's going on in here? This is my show. Stop the music. Stop them lights. You're not meant to enjoy yourselves without me. Jennifer McAlpine, come here. I think you should apologise to me.
Sorry.
And you costume characters, apologise.
Sorry, Hagger.
That's all right. I still don't understand why we've got a lemon. It's a bit weird, that is. Now, Jenny, you actors do your best to make soaps look like real life, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, let's have a look at some people who just can't get it right. Run those howlers, Derek. Oh, look, it's the Queen Victoria Public Inn. Oh, don't throw it. Oh, no, it's landed atop Phil Mitchell's bonsage. Now, everyone's looking at you, Phil.
Your blood pressure's normal.
Is it?
Your temperature's...
Look, it's through the roof. Your blood pressure. Jane, no, don't take his carrier bag. All his hankies are in there. He might need it. I told you, look. He had to use his hand. Filthy.
Is that what you want to talk about?
Now, you be careful with that ice cream on a summer's day. You've dropped your dairy produce, man. What are you playing at? Ian, no. Uh-oh, old Limpy Beale back on the scene. He's lost his shoe. One shoe, Beale. What a load of mooies, eh, Jenny? I bet you never get it wrong like that.
Oh, no. We are very professional at Coronation Street.
Well, it's a good job you said that, for I am going to put your soap acting skills to the test. Oh. I have written a top draw drama series, and I want you to play the role of Valerie Toothbrush, a down-to-earth cafeteria owner.
Right, and who are you going to play?
Most of the other roles, of course, for I am top draw and a dead good actor. Derek, run the titles! Oh.
Right, here you go. One grapefruit and Stilton pasta. Thank you. Oh, he's a right chicky monkey, that one.
Oh, hello, missus.
Oh, well, look who it is. If it isn't Mildred Wrongwhistle, the local battle act.
That's enough of the small talk, missus. I want something to eat.
OK, what can I get you?
I'd like a place.
Ah, well, you are in luck, Mildred, because today's special is actually place.
Hang on, I hadn't finished talking. I'd like a place to sit.
Oh, right, well... Go on, sit down here then. OK, What can I get you?
I'd like a place.
Yes, I've just told you today's special is actually place.
Not that sort of place. I want a place mat.
Oh, right. Here you go, then.
Now chuck that fish away and do as I order.
Now, what can I get you to eat?
Place, please. I believe it's today's special.
Yes, it is, and I've just chucked it away.
That does it. I'm never eating in this establishment again. Good day, sir.
Good riddance.
Oh, no, leave that. Oh, no, don't need it anyway.
I'll bring your wig after.
Cheers, love.
Who are my next customer's going to be?
Hello, lady.
Oh, well, hello. If it isn't Alfred Shoulderpad, the local old man.
Well, if it isn't me, then I best be going. Good day.
See ya. I wonder who my next customer will be. I said, I wonder who my next customer will be.
Give us a minute, love. I'm just getting my wig on. Hello, lady.
Oh, well, if it isn't Judith 12 Knuckles, the local hairdresser, what will it be?
Do you have frog's legs?
Yes.
Then you better go and get that seen to, love. Do you have pig's trotters?
Yes.
Then you better get that seen to as well. Do you have a trout's face, an outback's nose and a kangaroo's eyeball?
No, I certainly do not.
But that's what I really fancy for my lunch. In that case, I am never eating in this cafeteria again. Good day, sir. I'm off.
I wonder who my next customer will be.
Oh, hello, lady. I realised it was me after all. Oh, so I came back.
What would you like?
A new pair of windscreen wipers and a set of hubcaps, please.
But we only sell food here.
In that case, I'm never eating at this car mechanic's ever again.
Right, do you know, that's it. Hacker, I've had enough of this. I cannot stand here and be the butt of your jokes anymore.
Hey, where are you going?
I'm going to go and sit on the sofa and be the butt of your jokes in comfort instead.
Oh, fair enough. Why don't you lot watch some proper acting instead? It's time for the latest instalment of my detective series, Sherlock Bones. Run it, Derek!
Right you are, Mr. Hacker. Hoo-hoo!
This is the sinister town of Teapot.
Where trouble's always on the brew. It's a joke!
Sherlock, my diamonds have been stolen.
Since when have you been able to afford diamonds? I mean, I barely pay anything.
Sherlock, you've got to find out who stole them.
Oh, yes. For this is a case for Sherlock Bones.
I might have a dark and shady past, Mr. Beat, but I can assure you, that's all behind me now. Got it? Good. Right, moving on. What do you think of my new diamonds?
Stop, please! Every time. Anyway, I come in here on urgent business.
Right, well, it'll have to wait. I'm serving Mr. Bit while telling him about loving diamonds so much it's criminal.
Anyway, it's about this rash I've got. It's very red and sore. It's also quite flaky.
Mr. Bit.
Mr. Bit. Sherlock, have you got something to say?
Yes, I have, yes. I cannot go a moment longer without saying this. Mrs. Dew, you look divine in all those diamonds. But on an unrelated matter, has anyone seen some stolen diamonds?
What an odd question. Who'd steal diamonds? Not me, that's all in my past. Oh look, medicine.
Sherlock, do you think that Mrs. Dew might have something to do with this?
I don't know what Mrs. Dew and her insatiable love of diamonds has got to do with this.
Well, she's got a sign on her back that says, I definitely stole the diamonds.
We've all had signs on our backs, haven't we? Look.
Sherlock, I'm pretty sure that the thief is right in this room.
You stole the diamonds?
No.
Well, if you didn't steal the diamonds, that Mrs. Dew, did you do it?
No.
And Mrs. Dew didn't do it then. I must have stolen the diamonds. There's nothing left to do. I've got to arrest myself. Come on, me. Down the station. You'll never get me alive. Yes, I will. Stop whinging. Now you're hurting me arm. Stop being a wimp.
Sherlock, you've got it wrong.
What do you think of that, Jenny?
Yeah, it was good. I wouldn't give up your day job.
Ah, do you think you could get me a part in Curry? I can do lots of funny faces like Steve McDonald does. Look.
Come on, then. Oh, yeah, that's...
Oh, there's this one.
Oh, my favourite, he does.
Oh, yeah, that's uncanny.
He does that. What do you think?
Brilliant.
Well, we've had a lovely day, haven't we, Jenny?
Well, you have.
Well, one of us had to have. But quite frankly, I'm tiring of your company now, so you know, get out.
What? Hmm?
Yeah, you know where the door is, over there. Go on, make a move now.
Hang on. Don't you want to hear me showbiz anecdotes? I've got loads about Norris Cole, Emily Bishop.
No. That's your lot. Off you go now. Bye-bye. See you later, Jenny. And take that wretched anorak with you,
right,
please.
I will.
Sick of it. You mind me paintwork? You pull the door.
All right.
Pull it and mind your ear on the way out.
Thanks for having me.
No worries, love. What a lovely woman. I've got all her albums. Anyway, now that she's clean off, I'm going to show you some of the best lols from around the world. It's time for... Hacker's Top 3 Dramatic Howlers. In at 3, it's my main man, Disco Owl. Look at him dance. A lesser comedian would make a joke about him having a right hoot. But I'm better than that. At 2, I wouldn't want to get a slap from this hand. It's Kung Thumb. It's funny because it looks crass. And finally, you're going to be bowled over by our number one dramatic howler. Now, what's he doing here? Oh, look! It looks like, yes, you're right, he looks like he's going on strike! Apparently, he kept sliding all the way to Dunstable. Thanks for watching my little show today. It's been proper good, hasn't it? In fact, at times, I've been frightened by my own hosting talents. I'm off now, though, because I've got a pork loin defrosting in my kitchenette. So I'll see you next time. All that's left for me to do now is sing my well-good end song. Join in if you know the words. Good day! That is it for now, the end of the show. I need the lab, that's where I'm going to go. I'll see you next time on this show of mine. Put it in your diary, it's called Hacker Time. It's been amazing, we've been larking around. And we've been lolling at some clips that I found. We'll watch again next time, cause I got much more. There'll be tons of other funny stuff, it will be top draw. The lovely Jennie McAlpine dropped in to say hello. She's got a face and curly hair, but I had enough, so I told her it was time to go. That is it for now, the end of the show. I need the laughs, so I'm going to go. I'll see you next time on this show of mine. Put it in your diary, it's called Hacker Time. Put it in your diary, it's called Hacker Time. That is the end of today's Hacker Time.
If you howl with excitement every time you think about wolf blood, then you are in for a right old treat. For all the biggest wolf blood exclusives, presented by me, Dodge T-Dog, and my brother Hacker, press the red button. We've got insider information from the cast, and you can find out how they make those wolves so realistic. Oh, and trust me, there's much, much, much more in store when you press red. This special is only available for a limited time only, so please don't miss the opportunity. Thanks.